Hi students, how are you all? Fine. So have you seen the previous video in which we have started our second unit, that was Principles of Management? In that unit, in that video, we have discussed seven principles given by Henry Fayol. Henry Fayol has given fundamental principles of management. He has given total 14 principles, out of which seven were discussed in the previous video. So if you have not seen those, you first view that video and then come to this video. Okay. So in this video, we will proceed further and we will discuss the next seven principles. The eighth principle is centralization and decentralization. Now, before understanding what this principle is all about, first we have to understand what is the meaning of these two words, centralization and decentralization. Now, as you know, center kya hota hai? You must have seen circle has a center. Center means from here you can, the distance of any point on the circumference of the circle is equidistance from the center, and center holds the whole circle. If you want to draw a circle, you have to draw from the center. Center holds the whole circumference of the circle. In the same manner, when the whole powers, the all the powers of taking any decision is in one hand, is at the center. Center means here in one hand. For example, if in an organization, all the powers for taking any decision is in one hand, say for example, general manager. If there is, like we have studied the whole structure of business of an organization, there are shareholders, board of directors, then we have CEO of the company, and then we have so many different departments at the middle level. We have studied this in the previous unit that there are three levels of management. Upper level, means top level, middle level and lower level. In the middle level, we have so many managers for different departments. And the head of all these departments is one, that is general manager or CEO, whatever you call it, or the chairperson. So if in an organization, all the powers, decision taking powers are in one hand, that is in the general manager. Means the production manager cannot take any decision for his department. He has to rely on the general manager. General manager will take all the decisions regarding that particular department for the production manager, for sales manager, for every department. So all the powers in one hand. That is known as centralization, when all the powers are in one hand. Understood? Decentralization. Now whenever we add D to any word, it becomes its opposite. D means we are subtracting something. So when decentralization means just opposite of centralization. When the powers of taking decisions are distributed among all the subordinates. Means if general manager has given the powers to take decision regarding the department to all the departmental managers. For example, the GM means general manager has given production manager to take all the decisions regarding his department. Same goes with all the departments. He has distributed or given the authority to take any decision for their particular department to all the managers of different departments. So this is known as decentralization. Means he has distributed the powers. He has not kept all the powers with him. He has distributed. So this is just opposite, centralization and decentralization. So you understood the meaning of both the terms. Now when you know the meaning of both the terms, what this principle says, according to Henry Fayol, this principle says that there should not be complete centralization and complete decentralization. But in every organization, there should be effective centralization. Effective centralization. Now, what is the meaning of effective centralization? Means there should, this is also not correct, this is also not correct, this is correct. Means if a general manager keeps all the powers with him, then he has overburden. he will be overburdened for all the departments. If he has the power, he will be responsible for taking every decision. So he will be overburdened by so much work. Secondly, his subordinates, means the different managers of different department, they won't be learning anything. उनको सब कुछ पका पकाया मिल जाएगा. Means they don't have to take any decision. They won't be responsible for anything. वो एक कठपुतली की तरह काम करेंगे and they won't grow. They won't develop because they are just doing whatever they are being said. They are not taking any decision on their own. So उनकी growth भी रुक जाएगी. Plus they won't feel important in the organization and they won't work with full efficiency. So this is not a good condition, not a good concept. Decentralization. Now if the general manager gives all the powers, completely he distributes all the powers to all the managers and he doesn't keep any power with him, what happens? All the managers can misuse it. If someone is given all the powers, he can misuse it. So in this condition also, the company may suffer. Because isme then kya hoga? Every manager will think, I am the boss. I can take any decision. So he can take the decisions which are not good for the organization. Maybe he can fill his pockets. वो अपनी pockets अपने फायदे के लिए company का नुकसान कर सकता है. So this condition is also not good. Like for example, in a family, the head of the family is, for example, you must be having a joint family. If we are having a joint family, in joint family there is head means for example you have a dada dadi, your grandparents with you, your mother father. Your chacha chachi or tau taiji or whatever, and the kids. Now in a joint family, if centralization is observed, means all the powers are with dadaji or dadiji, and the for example the dadaji, then what happens? He will take all the decisions, so his sons will not become responsible because they will think everything is done by their father, so they won't grow themselves. Same manner for the ladies also, if the dadiji is taking all the decisions, then your mother or your chachi or your taiji, they won't work that efficiently because they'll think ki mama is going to do everything. But if this is centralization and if decentralization, everything is given to the younger generation, if you are given all the powers to do whatever decision you want to take, but you are not grown up enough, you can take wrong decisions also. So dada dadi should have some powers with them also. So what is effective centralization? Ineffective centralization, this is a mixture of both. Means in this, some powers are kept by the head and some powers are given to the subordinates. Means na to complete centralization, na hi complete decentralization. In effective centralization, some important powers, the powers to take important decisions are kept with the head and the daily decisions or the chote petty issues hote hain hamari company mein. So small decisions are, the power to take small decisions are given to the different departmental heads. So kya hota hai ki na to centralization hua ki we have given all the powers and we are holding all the powers and we are overburdened, and na hi decentralization hua ki we have distributed all the powers and now everyone is taking their own decision. Here we have some powers, important powers with us, and some powers are distributed, so it will help both. We are also not overburdened, the bosses are also not overburdened, and the subordinates also feel that they are important because they are taking some or the other decisions. So understood? Clear? Okay. Now the ninth one. Ninth is scalar chain. Scalar chain. Now what is scalar chain? Now as you must be understanding of the name chain. Chain means the one after another. So in chain, this principle, Henry Fowle states that there should be a line of authority in communication. Means whenever we are talking in an organization, here everything we are saying is in context of organization. So when we are working in an organization, now you have seen there are three levels. Top level, middle level, and this is lower level, and this is platform, that is the workers. Okay, now when the top level manager wants to talk to the labor, if top level manager wants to communicate something to the labor, means top level level management is making some policies or taking some decisions, and that are to be told to the labor or the workers. So will the top manager or will the CEO of the company will come to the labor and talk? No. How that message will move towards labor? So what this killer chain says is that whenever top level management wants to talk, or any level of management wants to talk to the next level, the communication should be in a line of authority. Now this is the line of authority. Line of authority means top level management won't speak to the labor. This cannot happen. The CEO of the company cannot go to the labor and talk to them. What will happen? Top level manager will convey the message to the middle level manager. Middle level manager convey to the lower level manager. And lower level manager, who is in direct contact with the labor, he will convey that message to the labor. So all the orders, top level management kya dega? Order hi dega. So all the orders should flow from top to bottom. Top to bottom. What orders? Orders will flow from top to bottom. And the suggestions or problems. Agar labor ko koi problem hai, ya labor want to give some suggestion ki the work should be in this way or the machine should be like this. If workers are having some problem or they want to give some suggestions to the CEO of the company, they won't go direct to them. They will tell the supervisor, that at the lower level, the supervisor will convey this message to the middle level manager, and middle level manager will talk to the top level manager. So whosoever is that link, they can only talk, others can't talk. So the suggestions or problems, they move upwards. Clear? So what scalar chain says is that the communication should be in the line of authority, the order should flow from top to bottom, and the suggestions or the problem should go from bottom to top. Ab isme ye bhi, agar middle wale ko kuch bolna hai, to he will talk, if middle wale ko isko kuch bolna hai, then the middle manager will talk to lower to manager. Means whatever, whosoever wants to talk to each other, they have to move in a line of authority. Now kya hua, jab ye principle diya gaya, it was not very easy principle. Because now it will take so much of time. Top will give to him, they will give to this. Ab isme kya hota hai? Jaise aap logon ne bachpan mein khel khela hoga, telephone. You must have played the game na? In a circle you used to sit and one will speak something in the ear of another. Then he will say the whatever he hears, he will say that to another person in his ears. And so the game goes on. And the last person from where the game started, when that sentence comes to the end, that sentence completely changes. Because when a sentence or a statement moves from so many people, it something is added and something is subtracted. So wo baat waise ki waise nahi pahunchti, kuch na kuch usme change ho jata hai. So so happens here also. Jo baat thi wo baat itni, because that particular order or problem, whatever it is, that message is conveyed from so many hands that it gets deteriorated, matlab wo kharab ho jata hai. That is why scalar chain ka ek exception aaya tha. Exception means if you want, you can use, you can change this principle, that is known as gangplank. Gangplank means, according to this, now this is also given by Henry Fayol, he named diya tha Henry Fayol, because after making this principle, Henry Fayol felt that this principle is very difficult to follow. It delays the decision. Abhi koi bahut jaldi decision lena hai aur itna der mein message hi nahi pahuncha ki wo decision already le liya gaya ya late ho gaya. So to avoid this, Henry Fayol gave this exception of scalar chain gangplank. It according to this, if a person at this level, for example in a middle level, ab isme kya hota tha कि जैसे टॉप लेवल पे है, मिडिल लेवल है, लोअर लेवल है. अब व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू हैपन अकॉर्डिंग टू स्केलर चेन, फॉर एग्जांपल ए बी सी डी ई एफ जी, दीज आर द पर्संस. डी इज एट द टॉप, ही इज द जीएम और जनरल मैनेजर. सी एंड ई आर एट द मिडिल लेवल, बी एंड एफ आर द लोअर लेवल, workers. Now, according to scalar chain, what used to happen, if A wants to say something to F, तो क्या स्केलर चेन चलती, A को F से कुछ बोलना है, तो A will say to B, B will say to C, C will say to D, D will say to E and E will say to F. So after following this much chain, the message of A reaches F. So it will take a long time. So gangplank says कि if A wants to say something, for example, अब ये तो level change हो गया. अगर same level में, for example, B को अगर कुछ F को बोलना है, तो भी वो ये scale use करेगा, chain use करेगा. लेकिन according to gangplank, अगर B को F से, अगर same level पे कोई बात करना चाहता है, तो he can directly talk. Means if using gangplank, B can directly talk to F. He don't have to move from this scalar chain. So this is the exception. Means you can avoid this principle and use gangplank instead. Understood? So these both principles are very important. All the principles are very important. But these, the scalar chain is something which is asked in exams again and again. So this must be clear. So you just read in the book. If you have doubt, we can clear it later. So I think you have must have understood. You can read in the book and then you can understand. Now we will proceed further. So now the 10th principle. 10th principle is order. What is order? Order, order, order. What is that? Everything should be proper. That is order. Order means, what this principle says? This principle says that everything in the organization should be at the right place, including the human resource. There are two types of order. Material order and social order. Now, what is material order? Material order, as you can say, it is related to the other resource, all the other resource, material resources, you can say. And social resource, social order is related to human resource. You already know what is human resource. Human resource means all the workers or human, or whatever human beings, whether employees, managers or workers, all are under human resource of an organization. So these two types of resources, material order and social order, these both should be at the right place. Means each person should be at the right job and each thing should be at the right place, and it should have its own place. Means each thing should have its own place and it should be at its own place. Now what is the difference? Means har cheez ki jagah honi chahiye. Like for example, at our home also, we keep everything in its place. Aapko pata hota hai ki aapki kaun si cheez ka, jaise hum aapki mama ko bolenge aapko koi cheez mangati hai ki please bring that from my almira. So they will tell you the exact place where it is kept, ki us almira mein us shelf pe ye cheez rakhi hai, just bring it on. Now how they know? Because they have made that particular place for that particular thing. They have given that place to that particular thing. In the same manner, in an organization also, we should give a particular place, we should assign a particular place for everything. We should know what, whenever we need something, we should know where it is kept. So each and everything should have its place and it should be kept at its place. उसकी जगह होनी चाहिए और वो चीज हमेशा अपनी जगह पे होनी चाहिए. बिकॉज वेन एवर वी विल नीड इट, इट शुड बी ईजी टू फाइंड इट देयर. अगर हम उसको यूज करके कहीं और रख देंगे, देन जब जरूरत पड़ेगी वी हैव टू सर्च फॉर इट एंड वी हैव टू वेस्ट अवर टाइम. सो इट इज बेटर दैट ईच पर्सन, नाउ इन द सेम एन अ पर्सन ऑल्सो, वेन एवर वी आर अपॉइंटिंग अ पर्सन, अपॉइंटिंग अ कैंडिडेट फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर जॉब, we should make sure that that person is capable of doing it. ऐसा ना हो कि जिसको हमने काम पे रखा उसको वो काम आता ही ना हो, या उस काम के लिए वो परफेक्ट ही ना हो, वो क्वालिफाइड ही ना हो. सो what this principle says is each person should be at the right job, right person should be at the right job and right thing should be at the right place. चीज अपनी जगह पे होनी चाहिए, उसकी एक पर्टिकुलर जगह होनी चाहिए, वो अपनी जगह पे होनी चाहिए, एंड द पर्सन whoever we are appointing for a particular post should be qualified enough. Understood? Easy tha bahut? Good. Next is equity. समझाने की जरूरत है. द वर्ड इक्विटी मीन्स हेयर इक्वालिटी. इक्वालिटी, इक्वालिटी मीन्स फॉर एवरी मैनेजर ऑल हिज सबॉर्डिनेट्स आर इक्वल. ही शुड ट्रीट ऑल द जितने उसके सबॉर्डिनेट्स हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अ सुपीरियर हैज एट सबॉर्डिनेट्स. फॉर हिम ऑल द एट सबॉर्डिनेट्स आर इक्वल. ही शुड ट्रीट देम इक्वली. ऐसा नहीं है कि किसी को तो डांट दिया और किसी को बिल्कुल भी नहीं डांट रहे. जिसको जिस चीज की जरूरत है, इफ समवन इज नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली ही शुड बी स्कोल्डेड. बट इफ द सेम मिस्टेक इज डन बाय अनदर वन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम अ मैनेजर एंड आई हैव सम सबॉर्डिनेट्स. इन दो सबॉर्डिनेट्स, वन ऑफ द सबॉर्डिनेट इज माई रिलेटिव और वन ऑफ द सबॉर्डिनेट इज माई फ्रेंड और अ नोन पर्सन. एंड इफ आई एम पार्शियल टूवर्ड्स हिम और हर, इफ आई एम नॉट स्कोल्डिंग हर बिकॉज शी इज माई नोन और शी इज माई रिलेटिव एंड आई एम स्कोल्डिंग द अदर पर्सन फॉर द सेम मिस्टेक विच शी हैज मेड, देन इट इज आई एम नॉट ट्रीटिंग दम इक्वली. बिकॉज एक को तो मैंने छोड़ दिया कि वो तो मेरा अपना है और एक को मैं डांट रही हूँ फॉर द सेम मिस्टेक, सो इट इज नॉट राइट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ बोथ आई हैव केप्ट टू एम्प्लॉइज अंडर मी, बोथ आर डूइंग सेम जॉब, बोथ आर सेम, बोथ आर इक्वली क्वालिफाइड, बट आई एम पेइंग वन लेस एंड वन मोर, देन आई एम नॉट ट्रीटिंग दम इक्वली. सो दिस इज रॉन्ग. बिकॉज वाई दिस इज रॉन्ग, बिकॉज इफ वी विल डू दिस इट कैन हार्म अवर पोजिशन ऑल्सो एंड दैट पर्सन जिसके साथ पार्शलिटी हो रही है शी और ही विल फील बैड, दे कैन लीव अवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. क्लियर? सो वी शुड ट्रीट ईच एंड एवरी एम्प्लॉय इक्वली सो दैट वी हैव अ गुड रैपो इन द सोसाइटी. Understood? Now we will move to the next one. Now moving forward to the 12th principle. 12th principle is stability of personnel. Stability. What is the meaning of stability? Stability means something which is not changing very frequently. Which is stable, which is constant, which is not changing again and again. And personal, not just see a difference between these two words. Personal, this personal means something relating to that particular person. जैसे मैं बोलूँगी कि मेरी personal चीज़ है, so something which is related to me, that is known as personal. But the see the spelling, we have double N here, and instead of A we are having here E. So what is this? This personal means human resource. So whenever this word comes, just understand that this word is related to the human resource of the organization. Clear? So stability of personnel means in an organization we should have our human resource stable. Means whoever person, employee is working in our organization, he or she should be stable. Means he or she should not leave our job very frequently. Why? Because if a person again and again leaves our job, it will add to our cost. Cost हमारी add हो जाएगी. कैसे होगी? Because जब भी हम कोई नया employee appoint करते हैं, it is related to a very long procedure. There is a long procedure attached to it. Because we have to first give advertisements in the newspapers and here and there that we need such and such employee with such and such qualifications. Then we will have a pool of applications, बहुत सारी applications आती हैं. We have to go through all the applications. We have to shortlist some which are up to the mark, up to the standard we have set, and some we have to reject with a sorry letter. Then whatever applications we get, we just go through it again. The best are called for the interviews. We take the interviews and then we select some good persons from them. Then we train them. उनको training भी देनी पड़ती है because sometimes they are raw means एकदम fresher होते हैं. अभी अभी उन्होंने पढ़ाई खत्म की होती है. We have to tell them how the work is done in our organization. उसको cope up करवाना पड़ता है हमारी organization से, उसको familiar करवाना पड़ता है. So all this whatever we have just seen the procedure, all this holds so much of cost. बहुत सारी पैसा लगता है हर चीज़ में, free में तो कुछ भी नहीं होता. तो अब क्या हुआ, हमने उसको रख लिया, कुछ दिन उसने काम किया और वो छोड़ के चला गया. फिर क्या हुआ, एक तो रेपुटेशन खराब होती है कि इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में कोई टिकता नहीं है, जल्दी छोड़ के चला जाता है. समथिंग इज रॉन्ग विद दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिकॉज पीपल आर लीविंग द जॉब अगेन एंड अगेन. तो उससे एक तो हमारी इमेज खराब होती है इन द मार्केट. दूसरा जब हम कोई नया एम्प्लॉय के लिए हम अगेन वही प्रोसीजर फॉलो करते हैं, देन अगेन इट एड टू आवर कॉस्ट, हमारी बहुत कॉस्ट होती है, बहुत हमें बहुत ज़्यादा कॉस्टली पड़ता है पूरा प्रोसीजर। तो इसीलिए हमें हर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को ये कोशिश करनी चाहिए दैट ही और वॉट एवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इट इज, दे द एम्प्लॉय शुड बी स्टेबल, दे शुड नॉट लीव अवर जॉब वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली। नाउ हाउ दिस विल बी अटेन्ड, हाउ दिस प्रिंसिपल विल बी फॉलोड, बिकॉज इफ वी कीप अवर employees happy, if our employees are happy with us, they are contented, they are satisfied, if we are treating them equally, if you are giving them good salary, fair remuneration, जैसे हमने principal पढ़ा था, fair remuneration देंगे, हम जितना काम करवाएंगे उसके according उनको अच्छा pay करेंगे, अच्छा treat करेंगे, सब कुछ discipline में रहेगा, जो भी principles हमने पढ़े वो सब follow होंगे, then वो happy होंगे, contented होंगे, तो वो हमारी job छोड़ के नहीं जाएंगे। So we should be able to keep them happy so that they don't leave our job. So this principle again is very important. Now the next one is 13th principle is initiative. Initiative. Initiative means taking the first step. Initiative का मतलब क्या होता है? Taking the first step. Now here what does this principle mean? This principle says that according to Henry Fayol, the manager should always try to encourage its subordinates to give good suggestions, and those suggestions should be welcomed. Means if a subordinate is giving some suggestions or wants to take part in management, he should be encouraged to do so. उसको हमें suppress नहीं करना चाहिए, उसको हमको दबाना नहीं चाहिए. Like for example, a supervisor wants to give some good suggestion, then middle level manager should not think कि ये तो मुझसे इतना लेवर लेवल पे है, ये मुझे क्या बताएगा, या आई एम मोर इंटेलिजेंट, वाई शुड आई टेक हिज सजेशंस। ही शुड नॉट थिंक लाइक दैट, ही शुड ऑलवेज वेलकम द सजेशंस गिवन बाय हिज सबॉर्डिनेट्स। हो सकता है कई बार कोई बहुत अच्छा सजेशन वो दे दे, तो इसलिए अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस प्रिंसिपल ईच एंड एवरी मैनेजर शुड ट्राई टू टेक सम सजेशंस फ्रॉम हिज सबॉर्डिनेट्स, द सबॉर्डिनेट शुड बी एनकरेज टू गिव देयर सजेशंस, एंड दो इफ यू फाइंड दैट सजेशंस गुड इनफ they should be implemented also, हमें उनको मानना भी चाहिए, so that it the our subordinates feel good, he feels encouraged to give us more good suggestions, because if good suggestions are being followed, it will make our working more efficient, हमारे objectives पूरे हो जाएंगे, हमें ज़्यादा profit होगा, clear? Good. Now the last one, 14th principle, this is esprit de corps. Now, what this principle says? This is the last principle given by Henry Fayol. It says that the manager should try that a teamwork is there in his organization. Means he should make his subordinates feel that they are also part of the organization. He should not boss over them. He should not always say, यहाँ पे एक मेन चीज़ आप पढ़ेंगे कि instead of I, he should use we. Like for example, if company has achieved something, if company has achieved good profits or whatever, then the manager should not say ki I have done it. He should say we have done it. अगर वो ये बोलेगा कि I have done it, तो बाकी को क्या लगेगा कि we are zero here, हमारा तो कोई value नहीं है. जबकि जितना lower level पे हम जाते हैं, the workers work more efficiently. जितना हमारे profit में जो हाथ workers का होता है, वो top level managers का नहीं होता है. Because the main working is done by the workers, so the manager should always use we instead of I. Means he should not say ki I have done it, he should say we have done it, so that the lower level managers or the subordinates feel important, they feel they are also valued, they feel that yes, they are also part of the organization. So a manager should always work as in a, he should always build in team spirit. Ek team spirit usko build up karni chahiye apni organization mein, जिससे कि सारे सबॉर्डिनेट्स उसके साथ मिलके काम करें. अंडरस्टूड? सो दिस इज डन, वी हैव डन विद द 14 प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ हेनरी फेयोर. सो दिस इज ऑल फॉर दिस वीडियो, फॉर दिस वीडियो वी हैव फिनिश्ड दिस द हेनरी फेयोर प्रिंसिपल्स, फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डू साइंटिफिक प्रिंसिपल्स गिवन बाय एफ डब्ल्यू टेलर. बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दैट, ऑल दीज प्रिंसिपल्स शुड बी अंडरस्टूड वेल. सो इट इज माई humble request to you all that please go through all this both these videos and just read in the book. You have, you all have books with you. You read in the book, you see the videos and try to understand it. Now you must, you will see in the book that we have some features and importance of principles before these principles, but we will not discuss it in the video. Whenever the school reopens, we will discuss those then, because I need some good space for those principles, sorry, those features and importance. In video that will be, won't be clear very easily, but I'll try ki video bhi main banau uske liye. But if we don't, then we will just do it again in the class. Whenever we will revise it, we will do it there. So in the next video, we will take our scientific principles. Okay, till then, you just take care of yourself, study well, stay at home, and stay safe.